Assalamu alaikum students, how are you? I hope that you will be fine and enjoying your summer vacations nicely at your homes. Students, today we are going to solve the remedy pack 2 of the level 9 and the subject is chemistry and the page number that we are going to solve today is 18. Students, at this page we have the remaining short questions that you have to learn and also write on your remedy pack. Number 6. What is the relation between electronegativity and polarity? Students, electronegativity is basically the force of attraction which attract the shared pair of electron towards itself. And polarity is basically the creating of the partial positive and the partial negative charges. So students, how these both terms relate to each other? So students, I will explain you with an example. Here we have hydrogen having a partial positive charge and chlorine having a partial negative charge. So why this partial positive and partial negative charge created? Due to the difference of electronegativity. Hydrogen has the 2.2 value, whereas chlorine has the 3.2 value. So the difference is 1. So due to that difference, they will be having the polarity in the molecule in the form of the creation of partial positive and partial negative charges, because this has more tendency to attract this shared pair of electron towards itself as compared to that hydrogen. So that's why it's carrying the partial negative charge and it is carrying the partial positive charge, and the covalent bond will be formed. Number 7. Differentiate between lone pair and bond pair of electron. So students, in this page you have to differentiate between the lone pair and the bond pair of electrons. Students, you have to draw the line between the bond pair and the lone pair and write down the differences. The first is, bond pair means the two electrons that will make pair and will be utilizing to form a chemical bond. Whereas lone pair is that pair of electron which will not involve in the bonding. So we called it as a non-bonded pair of electrons available on an atom. Students, here you can see that example of the bond pair. Hydrogen has one electron, and when it combines with another hydrogen atom which is also having the one electron, these electrons constitute the bond pair and allows the formation of the hydrogen molecule. Whereas in this ammonia, nitrogen has three electrons which are bonded with the three hydrogen atom, and the two electrons which are available on the nitrogen will be lone pair because it is free and available for the donation. So it is a non-bonded pair of electrons. 8. Draw Lewis dot and cross structure of nitrogen methane molecule. Students, Lewis dot and cross structure means they are basically the small dots or the crosses that are around the symbol of an element, and they will represent an electron. Students, this is a way of representing the types of the covalent bond. So, the diagram that we obtained by this method is called the Lewis structure diagram, as you can see here. The first is nitrogen molecule. So, students, nitrogen molecule forms a covalent bond which is triple in nature. Students, the electronic configuration of nitrogen is like that: 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. The number of electrons which are valence in nature are 5, in which the nitrogen forms bond with another nitrogen atom with the help of its 3 electrons. These 2 are the lone pairs, whereas these 3 are the bond pairs. It will combine with another nitrogen atom, and these electrons are shown by the crosses. Now, they will combine and form the Lewis dot and cross structure diagram. So, students, in this way, the triple covalent bond will be formed between the 2 nitrogen atoms. So, you can say that nitrogen is a type of the triple covalent bond. The next is the methane molecule. Students, methane molecule is an example of the single covalent bond. Students, this single covalent bond is formed when the carbon having the atomic number 6, 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. Students, there are 4 valence electrons present in the carbon, and these 4 valence electrons make bond with the 4 hydrogen atoms with the help of the dot and cross method. So, students, this will make the CH4, which is a methane molecule that we can also write as. So, students, you can see here every atom which is making bond with the carbon is contributing a single electron. In the same way, the carbon is contributing to each of the hydrogen atom a single electron. So, in this way, a single covalent bond will be formed in the methane molecule. Number 9, on the page number 19 of your remedy pack, give the formation of the polar covalent bond in HCl molecules. Students, polar covalent bond means the covalent bond which is polar in nature. So, students, polar means having partial positive and partial negative charges. So, students, on the base of the partial positive and the partial negative charges, the covalent bond will become polar. But how this happens? Like, we have hydrogen plus chlorine, this will form hydrogen chloride. Students, this hydrogen atom has only 1 electron. This chlorine atom has 7 electrons in its valence shell. They will combine with each other by the covalent bond and form the HCl. So students, this bond will prove to be polar because the covalent bond is formed between the two different atoms, in which one is hydrogen and the other is chlorine. Hydrogen has electronegativity value different as compared to the chlorine. So they will arise the partial positive and the partial negative charges on them. In this way, the bond will become polar. So this is called the polar covalent bond. Number 10. Why the electrons move freely in metals? Students, metals are the type of the elements that are having huge number of the free electrons. So they will become easy for the losing of electron. On the base of them, we call them as the metals. So today we have to find the reason that why the electrons which are present in the metals are of the free nature. So you have to make the heading here, movement of electrons in metals. That is because of the several reasons. Some of them are the nucleus hold on the outermost electron is weak because the size of the atom of the metal is large. So the number of shells in between the nucleus and the outermost electron will be more. So the electrons give a chance to move freely in the metals. They have the low ionization potential, means they can easily lose electrons by just acquiring a small amount of energy. So due to that reasons, we can say that electrons will be moving freely in the metals. Students, that is all about our today's lecture. I hope that you clearly understand all the short questions. We will meet tomorrow in our next video. Till then, Allah Hafiz.